where is the best place to live in Berlin? Is it here or here? Definitely not here. The answer to that is not so easy, because it really depends on who you are and what you're looking for. You really think that those four guys would become happy in the same district? Didn't think so. After all, Berlin is a massive city. But that's why I'm here. After this video, you will feel more local than someone who has lived here for years. I'm going to show you which are the most important ones, what kind of people usually live there, and what's the best and worst about the district itself. Let's cut the crap and dive into it. Berlin is divided into 12 major districts and even more sub-districts. But the only interesting ones are inside the ring, because nobody wants to live outside the ring. Nobody. Let's start with the district I live in, Neukölln. Neukölln is the current runner-up of the city. It is getting more and more gentrified, but housing and other things are still relatively cheap. It has a long-standing Middle Eastern community. There's plenty of fresh fruit stands and markets, Middle Eastern restaurants and shops. It almost feels like being in Istanbul. The district can be divided into three parts: the cool part, the shitty part, and the pretty part. Yes, Neukölln has also some nice corners, especially around the Richardplatz. In recent years, there have been moving in a lot of students and hipsters, and there have been popping up more and more bars around. I would even say that Neukölln has at this very moment the coolest bar scene in Berlin, with the Weserstraße being the heart of it. It's less touristy than the Simon-Dach-Straße, and the drinks are much cheaper. Neukölln is also the area with the highest amount of Hartz-IV-Empfänger in Germany. That meaning people who are unemployed and receive government benefits. Some bars even specialize on those people. Statistics say it's more than 1 in 4 people. What's also great is that the Tempelhofer Feld is right around the corner. One of the biggest city parks in the entire world. It used to be a major airport, and now it is a popular spot in summer to have a barbecue or to let your dragon fly. Neukölln is probably going to change a lot in the coming years. Once gentrification is in the process, it's not going to stop. The best thing about living in Neukölln, in my opinion, is the amazing bar scene. And also having all those amazing fresh fruit stands around. The worst is probably that even that Neukölln is a pretty safe space, there are a lot of weird people hanging around. A little bit north of Neukölln is Friedrichshain. Friedrichshain is one of the liveliest parts of Berlin. There's countless shops, restaurants, bars and clubs. Although most things are happening in the bottom part. In the upper part, there's not really much going on. Friedrichshain has a very mixed population. It used to be a left-wing hotspot, with a lot of punks and anarchists living in it. But over the years, it got super gentrified. They have completely redone the district. Today, there's only a few squat houses left, which they are defending with everything they have. Occasionally, they still burn some cars on the street. Now, it's a mix of those punk remainers, families, and actually a lot of expats, mostly from Europe. Thanks to all the bars and clubs around, Friedrichshain has become a major hotspot for nightlife tourists. With the Simon-Dach-Straße being the tourist street in Berlin. Right around the corner is also the RAW area. With its many clubs and being the graffiti and street art epicenter, it can be considered the coolest place in all Berlin. The best thing about living in Friedrichshain is the insane amount of great restaurants and clubs you can choose from. If you live here, you can always walk home. But of course, if you're not into this kind of stuff, all the action can be pretty annoying. especially around the Simon Dach and the Warschauer Straße. Also, because it has become so touristy, prices for everything have been going up a lot. It's time for Mitte, the heart of the city. I would love to live in Mitte. That's a sentence no Berliner would ever say. It's great to visit, but not for living. Most sightseeing spots are here. There's the Brandenburger Gate, the Fernsehturm, the Dome, about 100 museums, and other countless historic sites. Also not to forget, a lot of shopping malls. Because of that, it's super crowded with tourists. And it makes eating out or meeting at a bar quite expensive. If you got a job, you're most likely to work in Mitte. Most office spaces are located here. The area around Torstraße is also home to the Berlin startup scene, also known as Silicon Alley. The best thing about living in Mitte is that it's central. It won't take you long to go anywhere. If you're into historic sites and like to be around old, impressive buildings, Mitte is your district. In the far west, there is Charlottenburg. Charlottenburg has a lot of very wealthy people living in it. The average age of the population is also much higher. There's also a pretty big Russian community living in this area. Some people even call it Charlottengrad. The most well-known street here is Kurfürstendamm, with its many high-end luxury shops around. It's mostly a posh area. Food in restaurants costs significantly more than in other districts. There's also not many bars and almost no clubs around. Even the Spätis seem missing. But there are a lot of beautiful buildings. Being in Charlottenburg feels very different. It doesn't feel like being in Berlin at all. There's not much going on. Everything's pretty, buildings have no graffiti, and even people dress differently. It has nothing in common with the cool and hip Berlin people know. So I guess the best thing about Charlottenburg is that it's quiet, and if you're lucky enough to be rich, you can go shopping in all those expensive, fancy shops and get one of those super pretty apartments. The worst thing about living here is that it's boring. And if you want to go anywhere where something is happening, it'll take you quite some time. A little more southeast is Schöneberg. Schöneberg is a quite interesting district. It can be divided into a quiet southern part and an active party-like north. The northern part is famous for Europe's biggest department store, the KDW, which is not for someone with a small budget. But in the area are countless small designer shops as well. Schöneberg has also probably the highest number of second-hand shops in Berlin. Not a kind of cheap, I have no money second-hand shops, but a kind of I go vintage hunting ones. People call Schöneberg also the Rainbow District. It has a very big and active LGBT community. There are a lot of gay bars and clubs around, and you can feel that flair on the streets. If you're a part of this community, there couldn't be a better district. A little bit to the right, there is Kreuzberg. It has a well-established Turkish community. But in the last 10 years, all kinds of alternative people have taken over. Every creative, DJ or student wants to live here. Kreuzberg can be divided into two areas. The cool, young and hip part with a lot of nightlife, and the more family-friendly part. Both are divided by the Landwehrkanal, which is a popular spot to hang out in summer. Kreuzberg has by far the youngest population in Berlin, and you see that on the streets. There's always something going on. There are countless bars, clubs and restaurants. And together with Friedrichshain, they form the hippest and coolest part of Berlin. It may even be too cool for its own good, because in recent years, prices for housing have been going up a lot. Living in Kreuzberg is not for everyone. But if you're into alternative lifestyles and love the nightlife scene, it's a dream come true. There's only one spot one should avoid to move to, and that's the Corpusator, which is always swarming with junkies and not the friendly ones. Next up we have, in the far north, Prenzlauer Berg. It can be divided into a quiet and not so pretty part and a trendy and beautiful part. Pieberg has a fascinating history. It was once one of the poorest districts of the city, which was attracting a young bohemian crowd. But those days of poor artists living on cheap rents in crumbling buildings are over. Since the reunification, the district has transformed into a wealthy but still trendy area, and the poor bohemians have been replaced by rich bohemians. Today it looks more like Munich rather than Berlin. It's clean, it's pretty, and it's full of organic supermarkets and vegan restaurants. When you're walking down the streets, you see an insane amount of baby buggies. It seems like everyone who wants to have children in Berlin is moving here. Understandably. Some people even call it the Latte Macchiato Momhood. So most people here are young families. And people from the south of Germany, like Swabians and Bavarians. Because they're generally wealthier and they like it pretty. Feels just like at home for them. Prenzlauer Berg is also hosting Berlin's most popular flea market at Mauerpark. If you didn't know, Berliners love flea markets. Every Sunday, there are dozens of them all over the city. Visiting a flea market on a Sunday is every Berliner's favorite activity, just after laying in bed with a hangover. When deciding about where to live, it's also important to keep in mind that you're probably going to spend most of the time only in your district and maybe the two or three surrounding ones. Berlin's districts are so unlike that they all feel like different cities. There's also not one big city center, but every district has their own small one. Since Berlin is such a huge city, you'll think twice about going to the other side of town, which will take you at least 45 minutes. That's also why it's advisable to live inside the Ringbahn, because public transport there is so good and accessible. The only reason to move outside the ring is either because you're low on cash and you're looking for affordable housing, rents there are much cheaper, or that you just like to live in the suburbs. If you guys would like to know more about the districts outside the ring, or more in-depth videos about the already mentioned ones, let me know. I hope this gave you a good overview over the city. If so, smash that like button and happy moving. No one ever regretted moving to Berlin.